This is a performance test, how fast I can load and render a complex B-spline surface. Our test case is this file. I have a plane and I have here added property mode. Mode data means that I only load the data. I can switch to the grid mode, and in this case we get a B grid of this surface. The surface has 30 times 30 cells, that mean about 1000 cells, and these are 3000 control points nearly. And oh no, that means 10,000 control points. So, and I can switch from this mode to data, where nothing is displayed, to grid, and the default mode is the mode where the surface is rendered. This will take a little time, so we can see what happens here. We see first here the CPU load, and we see also here how the memory usage changes. And okay, we have it here, and we can switch back to the grid mode, and it's nearly in real time. And so I close the file, and now I will do a small performance test, and then we will look at the data. Okay, I run the script. So now I load three different files. One file where only the data are loaded, one file where the grid is loaded, and the last file where the complete surface is stored in the file. And then I do some changes, and then we will have here the data. Okay, first let's look at the load. We have here the load. If we load a complex model, we have it here. And we have here the same when we change from the grid to the real mode. That means the difference here is about 200 megabyte. And we see here the performance. Okay, and now let's look at the times. And let's start here. The first load is the data file only with the data, and it takes us 0.2 seconds. The second test is I load the grid. I need nearly the double time. It's still fast enough. It's less than 1 second. And in the last case, I load the complete phase. We see it here. It takes us about 19 seconds. That is more than 100, or it's about 100 the time of the pure data load. So when I have loaded the pure data here once more, then I can render the grid, and the change from the data to the grid is nearly 0.156. This is fast enough, but the switch from the grid to the default surface is again 18 seconds, and this is very much time. So we have this here, and if we have this complexity, we can now ask, is it possible from here to generate some volume? One possibility is to create volume for each cell. That means I create something like an offset. And I will start this. I create a splitter cells. This means I create the offset objects. Let's start. And we can Wait a little bit, I stop the recording. So we have finished. Now we see it takes us about 1.5 minutes. We have here constant memory usage, and now we have here the result offset object as a volume for each cell. And now I can try to change here the view, and we see if I change the view, I need a lot of CPU load, and I also see that here more memory is used. So to illustrate what we have done for a simple case, I start again with a simple cell. Okay, we start a simple case. The first thing what we do is we create such a B-plane, and we add here some noise on it, and we see it, and now we can change the mode. The mode is from default to grid and to data, and back to grid and to data. And from here I can create some segments. I split it into cells. So we have here the result, and the result in this case are offset volumes, and I can hide some of them. So we see all this volume. This what I have done here for a very small plane in the experiment we have done for about 1000 cells.